Hello everyone, welcome back to another custom spotlight. After the interesting one that was our last review, I thought that we should go on a little more something interesting. Now, I bet you're wondering, why does everything look so different this time around? This isn't Trackmaster, what is this? Well, why don't I go ahead and bring in our first subject? Our first subject for today, Geotrax Thomas. Now, I bet some of you are wondering, what is a Geotrax? Well, for those who don't know, Geotrax is a line of toy trains made by Mattel back in the early 2000s. They had steam engines, diesel engines. They're basically RC toys. And they were really fun to play with, and they were honestly, I think, besides Thomas, the most popular toy trains. And they never made Thomas for it, even though Mattel at one point owned both Geotrax and Thomas. And honestly, it's kind of disappointing that they never made some. I know a lot of people, including myself, would have loved to have Geotrax Thomas as a kid. In fact, I've always wanted one myself, so I've been on the hunt for Geotrax this year to make a Thomas. And I happened to find a lot that came with some engines, and, well, I finally made Thomas. So, if we take a look here, Thomas is made from the Silver Bullet engine. He uses the shell of a pullback My First Thomas. Let me grab an example here. While not the same type of model, well, it's the same model, just a different year. His wheels were taken off and made to fit on the bottom. Made to fit on the motor. You can see a lot of the dent marks and creases. At the back here, there was room to allow the battery compartment to be accessed, even though I found a way around that. His body has been modified to sit on the Geotrax shell, speaking of which, the body is removable, so is the footplate. This whole thing is basically an interference fit, kind of like Leo Kim Video's Pez Gandhi Dancer Thomas. At the top here, you can see a hole made for Thomas's light, as well as the on-off switch for Geotrax engines. Even though it doesn't really do anything, and I just put it there for aesthetic. So if we take Thomas, we can, in fact, take his shell off and footplate and get a better look at how much I had to take apart to allow Thomas to fit. And the footplate as well. The motor itself, too, had to be heavily modified to allow Thomas to fit. And to put it on, here's how you do it. Take the foot plate. Kind of want to get it around the halfway point. Then you got Thomas. You just kind of push him on there. It takes a little while. Got to get it in the right spot. But you can push him down. Fix the foot plate, and boom! Thomas fits. And he does, in fact, run. Now, to go along with our good friend Thomas, we have his faithful coaches, Annie and Clarabelle, made in the Geotrax style. Now, I would have loved to use the Discovery Junction, or Discover Junction, whatever it's called, Annie and Clarabelle models, but I don't have those. So I just went ahead and repainted the Silver Bullet coaches. So here's Annie. I tried my best to replicate her face and replicate her little cursive. It's not really that good. Just repainted the entire model. Some white handrails. There's Annie again. Then we have Clarabelle. Her cursive, handrails. Same on the other side. and her face. And the three of them can all fit nicely together. And I believe that's all for Thomas, so let's let him continue on his way. Oh yeah, he is also a very poor runner. But who knows? Maybe our other engine will have a better chance at running than him. Now, apart from Thomas, I bet you're wondering, who else did I make? Well, for those of you who have seen my Twitter post and the community section post, you should know who's coming next. But for those who don't, let me bring him in. Our next engine up is Percy the Small Engine. Now, Percy, like Thomas, was modified to fit the Geotrax motor. Although, unlike Thomas, Percy here uses the My First Push-Along version, along with another character who sadly was unable to get a model for round one. So Percy, he has been modified to fit on the shell of, I don't remember which engine this is, it's the one with the blue remote. I don't know Geotrax, I don't remember my Geotrax names. You can see the marks like Thomas, but unlike Thomas, I realized I didn't have to have an area where the little battery compartment needs to be accessed. So Percy doesn't have that. He does, however, still have the power button and the one to see the light. Now, in addition, like Thomas, Percy can also be taken apart. Now, unlike Thomas, Percy has been a little harder to work as time went on. He worked perfectly at first, but his battery compartment always doesn't get in there right, so I have to tape it up before using him. That's why it's covered in tape, but it does work. Although for some reason the sounds don't, I don't understand that. But yeah. Here's a look at Percy's insides. You can tell a lot has been molded away. The smoke box, like Thomas, well, the front have been super glued to the bodies, for the record. And then here's his foot plate. His pistons had to be super glued on because they were a part of the bottom. And then if we put that together and then grab the shell and fit it on. Now Percy also has some rolling stock. Here we have a generic Season 1 truck. I basically just gave it the eyes and the mouth. That's all this is. And then a Sodor line caboose, which is just the little caboose with painted black parts and Sodor written on the sides. And for those wondering, Percy is, in fact, faster and stronger than Thomas. If I would have known that, I would have gave Thomas this motor and Percy the motor to the Silver Bullet. Oh well, I'm probably going to make a Thomas version 2 anyway. But I did have 3 engines. Well, technically I have 4. There's this one, but I can't really use that one for now. But I did have 3 engines. I tried to motorize all of them, but the third motor couldn't be utilized. I did, however, make one more engine. Percy, if you could go fetch him, that would be great. All right, Percy, bring him in. Here we have the last of the engines for this round. James the Splendid Red Engine. Now, my original plan was to, of course, make James motorized, like Thomas and Percy back there. But I only had one motor left, and that was to a tender engine. Now, my second idea was to take this shell, plop it on this chassis, like I did, but take off the tender and give the tender motor like a Trackmaster James tender or something. That tender could not fit this shell, Thomas's shell, Diesel's shell, or just any shell in general, no matter how hard I tried. I almost got James's shell on there, but it didn't fit. So I scrapped that idea and just slapped James's body onto the chassis of the tender engine, took off the side rods because he couldn't work with the side rods. And now James is a just push-along engine. Now if I grab Percy here, we'll see Percy have his back coupling sticks up, while James's is a loop. So if you put James can be put on the back of an engine and be pulled around. And that's basically it for James. Now, unlike Thomas and Percy, James is actually glued in place. Well, of course, Thomas and Percy can be taken apart. Also, a little update on Percy. This is actually, I'm filming this the second day, and I fixed Percy's screws, so now he can work a little easier. But yeah, that's basically it for Geotrax, Thomas, Percy, and James. Now, if you'll notice, I did put some things in the background, like the My First Herald, Bathtoy Captain, and the Trackmaster Cranky, because they do fit in scale. Those are probably the only non-rail vehicles I'll do. But to answer the question about more characters, yes, there will hopefully be some more in the future. I just need to get more engines to run them first. Like Diesel, he will probably end up being the next character. Now, but you're wondering, why don't you use this steam engine that you showed off earlier? Well, you see, I take that. Diesel's a little too big. I have some ideas on who to make next and what to make them out of, but those will come at a later date. Anyway, this has been the Geotrax Thomas Custom Spotlight. Now, if you can go ahead and take everyone out, Percy, that'd be great. Until next time, catch you later.